Very good afternoon to all of you. So in the last class we have seen we have started session tracking, right? Session management or session tracking. And we see the first thing called cookies, right? How to create cookie, how to insert data into the cookie and how to access the data from the cookie and how to validate the particular user by using these cookies. Okay, today we will see the continuation of that. Cookies is completed, so we will see hidden form fields for session management. Okay. Most in one more session, this class will be completed. Okay, so today we will see hidden form fields and URL rewriting. Okay, in the next session we will see HTTP sessions. Okay, by seeing this HTTP session, we will close the training. Okay, mostly you can expect one or two sessions. Mostly one session. If it is not required, we will take one extra session. Please wait. Browser is not responding properly. Meanwhile, if you have any questions, you can ask me. Okay. you can unmute and you can ask me questions, okay? If required or if any. So let us explain what is hidden form phase. See, forget about cookie. Okay, cookie will be stored at client side, right? But this time no cookies, and we are using hidden form phase. What is meant by hidden form phase? In HTML, you may see text boxes, right? Similar to that, there is a concept called hidden form field. Okay. So whenever you created a HTML form, you will provide what? A hidden form field. Okay. E hidden form field, a client key means in the browser the client cannot see this form field. Okay, so even user don't know whether there is a form field or not. Okay, it is hidden, no one can see that, especially only at server side a programmer can see. Okay, so still it is loading. Okay, okay. Let us see hidden form field. Let me close all these things. Okay, we will see hidden form fields and URL retrieving. Okay. So I have already created this file. Okay. Code will not be complex. Okay. For understanding purpose, we have taken only two classes, two servlets, and two, three HTML pages. Okay. So first, let me run this. Okay. So run on server. So click on finish. So Tomcat is talking.
So this is the index.html file. So in this, you can give some name, x, y, z. Okay. So click on go. You see, welcome, x, y, z. It is identifying me as x, y, z, right? So click on go. Hello, x, y, z. Another page. See, this is the first response, and after that, if you click on go, then this is the another response. Okay, see the URL right now. From here onwards, see, exploited. Let me change this. Yeah. So go. This service means this request is being sent to what? A first server. Okay, so a username. This is nothing but we are calling this servlet, and we are passing this attribute means key value pair will be sent to this servlet along with the request. Question mark is used to pass extra value to the servlet. Okay, means what we are doing is we are appending this value to this servlet. Okay, so we are passing username equals to Naga. This is the name of the attribute, and this is the value of that attribute. Okay, so by clicking on go, we are moving towards second servlet, right? And here also, what we are doing, we are passing username and Naga. Okay, see how it is being transferred from one servlet to another servlet without cookies, right? Do you see any cookie? ఇంకా కోడ్ ఓపెన్ చేయలేదు కదా సో దెర్ విల్ బి నో కుకీ బట్ హౌ ఇట్ ఈస్ హ్యాపెనింగ్ మీన్స్ బై యూజింగ్ హిడెన్ ఫార్మ్ ఫీల్డ్స్ హౌ దీస్ హిడెన్ ఫార్మ్ ఫీల్డ్స్ విల్ బి యూస్డ్ టు హ్యాండిల్ ద సెషన్ వెదర్ ఈజ్ ఇట్ అ గుడ్ వే టు హ్యాండిల్ ద సెషన్ మేనేజ్మెంట్ టు వాట్ ఎక్స్టెంట్ ఈజ్ ఇట్ గుడ్ ఓకే వీ విల్ సీ దీస్ Now let us open the code. First open HTML. You will see a text box, a go button. This is taking time. Please wait. For example, the questions will be on JDBC programming, servlets, even on core Java also, okay? You can expect questions on core Java. Though it is multiple choice questions, the questions will be on core Java also, okay? Whatever I discussed, you can expect questions from there, but not in coding questions, okay? Coding questions can be different. So I told you right earlier, exam will be either on Thursday or Friday, but it will not be on Thursday or Friday. Okay. So within this week, we will have exam, but not on Thursday or Friday. It's Thursday means this day, right? Today. Yeah. Maybe you can expect on Saturday or Sunday. Okay. It depends. I will intimate you earlier. Okay. So see the form. First servlet. See, we are having more a text box, a button, and this is the form. We are mentioning this inside the form. See, on clicking this button, we are redirecting to first servlet, right? So what is the code we are having in first servlet? So we are taking the input here. What is the input here? Username, right? We are taking
use name as input from the form, okay? And we are getting that input by using get parameter, okay? So this is username, and we are storing it in a variable n, and we are printing welcome name, okay? Next. This is okay. Up to this, no problem. Okay. Just now he requested the server, it gives response to the client by using it, by displaying his name. Okay. But when this request has been transferred to another resource like another servlet or JSP, then that servlet or JSP must know who is this client, right? In order to remember that, what we are doing is we are creating a form. See here, out dot print of form action second servlet, out dot print of input type hidden, name equals to uname, value is equals to n, and input type is equals to submit. The button name will be go. Okay, so I'm closing the form. What does it mean? See, you can display, you can redirect the request to HTML directly. Okay, simple ga ela cheptunte request dot get dispatcher servlet of ani manam oka servlet oka HTML name isthunnam kada ela ante request dot get dispatcher servlet. Here we are mentioning what HTML, right? What it is doing internally, it will find this HTML and it will print the display the HTML on the browser. But you can also do like this, but you need to enter all the code inside the double quotes. Means you are printing this on what you are printing on text slash html. Hope you understand now why we are using set content type, why we are setting the type of the content. Now we are displaying the text in the form of html, so browser will take this as input, and browser will understands html code, right? So it will convert this text into HTML tags, okay? So that it will create a form, okay? What we have in that form, this will not be displayed. This also will not be displayed. Only this will be displayed. Why? So far you have seen input type equals to text, button, submit, radio box, checkbox, right? So this is one more thing called hidden. Means you cannot see this in field, okay? You cannot see this input field. The reason of this is it will hide the input field, okay? So user cannot see, but from the server side we can see. See here, what you are doing here is we are appending this username to this value. So far we have didn't assign any value, right? Button ka assign chesam for go. Input text ki means input form field ki manam type value ni enter cheyam, okay? Why? So we are not the person to give the value here, right? User has to enter the value. But when it comes to hidden form fields, internally you are providing value here. So why should you are providing like this? Because I want to remember this user in another resource. How? Without using cookies, how can I remember? Hey man, just take some name and take this reference along with you, so that whenever a new request came and check whether this person is the same person or not. Okay. And what user can see is just this button. Okay. Whenever you click on this go button, this form will be submitted. On submitting of this form, the control will be transferred to the second servlet, right? So Next, the control will be transferred to second servlet, right? Now, see, it is taking means from wherever you are taking request, that request can be transferred. Means, in the first servlet, kada. So, this request object is having this form field data. Okay, this form field data to part the incarnation data kuda untundi. It will be stored in the header. Okay, request header. And whatever the response you want to send to the sends to the client, that will be provided in this. You may observe this. Why we are getting writer by using response? Only response having the data which will be sent to the client. Okay, request is responsible for bringing the data from the client, and response object is responsible for providing data back to the client. Okay, that's why we are creating a print writer object by using response only, not with a request. Right, so on clicking this button, it will be redirected to what? Second servlet. Okay, so here again we are setting the content type to HTML. We are getting response from get writer because we want to print something onto the browser. Okay, that too in the form of HTML only. You can say these are MIME types. Okay, vitimana MIME types ani antam. So string n is equals to request dot get parameter of username. Okay, see how you are getting this username, a request dot get parameter. Who provided this parameter to the request? Whenever you are transferring this control from first servlet to second servlet, this request has been forwarded to this servlet. Okay, automatically whatever the data you have sent to from that place to this place, it will be available in the request object. By using this request object, we are getting that data, right? So we can also change this okay, we are directly providing this value here. So now we are getting the parameter value here. Now see here, what is this uname? This uname is the parameter name of this form. Okay, hidden form. By using this uname, we are getting value of the username. Okay, from here this value we are getting from previous request, means first request. Okay, so we are getting n and we are printing hello plus n. This is not appropriate to handle the session, to handle sessions. Okay, to remember the client across the web pages, because if you observe this, how we are handling this session management here means by using hidden forms. Okay, so if you follow hidden form fields to handle the session management, what you need to do is you need to add forms. You need to mention a hidden form field. You need to provide the form. Is it appropriate to mention the forms in every request, every servlet? It is not possible, right? So you can expect this, or you can use this when the user disabled the cookies. Okay, cookies can be disabled by the user. Okay, at the time of cookies is disabled, we can use this hidden form fields. Okay, because you cannot restrict the user to stop disabling cookies, right? So we can use hidden form fields, but not in each and every servlet. Okay, wherever you need, you can use. Okay, just like a feedback form or something, just a feedback form. Okay.
So clear?
Screen invisible, sir.
Screen invisible. I already shared my screen. It is already shared. Maybe you may face some network issues.
No, okay, sir.
इधर क्यों की स्क्रीन कांड पहुंच लेगा?
काशे पूछें से तरवाता पुइंडी.
Okay, maybe it is your internet issue. Okay. So clear after this. Now, don't think I'm showing with only two servlets. If you want to implement this with your own examples, you can create multiple servlets. Okay, I have already told you implement multiple HTML pages and use multiple servlets. Means create multiple servlets to handle a particular request. Okay, you can take a simple application. Consider a student application for library management, submitting the book. Submitting the book servlet, okay. Next, applying for book, one servlet means taking request, okay. ఇలా మీరు ఒక సింపుల్ గా ఒక 4-5 సర్వ్లెట్స్ ని క్రియేట్ చేసి ఒక్కొక్క సర్వ్లెట్ ఒక్కొక్క స్పెసిఫిక్ రెస్పాన్సిబిలిటీని హ్యాండిల్ చేసేలాగా క్రియేట్ చేయండి. దెన్ యాడ్ ద డేటాబేస్ కనెక్టివిటీ కోడ్ ఇన్ దట్, ఓకే, సో దట్ యూ మే అండర్స్టాండ్ హౌ దిస్ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు హౌ దీస్ concept will work. Okay. Maybe in cookies also I didn't added multiple servlets or HTML pages, right? So here you can add multiple servlets, and in order to handle session management, you need to mention this, you need to provide this hidden form in every servlet, because one servlet and another servlet will communicate by using request and response, right? So in order to pass the data, you can provide in the form of request. Means you can provide data in the request, okay? And so that is how you can do, okay? No external HTML pages, okay? Even though if you take a hidden form means HTML page, there also you can mention hidden form fields. Okay, ikkada rasindhi meer em chestaru, inkoka HTML form lo rastaru, means like this index.html you will create one more HTML, but ikkada meeku telindi entante inta varaku manam form nunchi data ni teeskuntunnam kani means form to servlet we are taking data, but from servlet we are not displaying the data onto the form, right? Okay, enda teeskotledu teeskuntunnam annu meeku anipiste chudandi, we are providing, means we are just displaying the data on the browser, right? Do you see any form here? Now you can do one thing. Means we are created form here, but it is not here, right? So we need to pass this value to the new form. Means ikkad nunchi manam pass chese data ikkada unna html page ki append avali, right? Like like this it should. Now HTML page will ask you, sir, what is this n? Let me know first. What is n here? N is nothing here. Then who told you, sir, n is came from the servlet and this is have some value, right? So this is not possible here. Okay, if you use JSPs, it will be possible. Okay, so that is the thing you need to observe here. Okay, this is about hidden form fields. Next thing is URL relating. Okay, all these concepts are related to session management. What is session management? Means identifying the user across the pages. Okay, what is the use of remembering the user? Because user may perform multiple operations, but we need to know who is operating on what resource. Okay, we will not give permissions to access all the pages. Do you see some applications? Some options will not be enabled, right? Why? Because you are not authenticated authorized persons to perform some operations. Okay, how they gonna do that? They will take your data. Means suppose a manager and a team member is there, so they will check the check some functionality. Means maybe they remember some ID or some code. Okay, based on code they will restrict the access. Okay, if manager code means if the employee code is equals to manager, then disable this. Okay, like that. You will see these kind of things in real applications. Okay. Next, URL rewriting. So let me run this first. By observing all these things, finally you can conclude that sessions are better to manage session tracking. Okay, session means HTTP session. Hope you remember what is HTTP. It is a protocol. So in that they designed a concept called session. Okay, by using that HTTP session, we are going to manage the session plan. So let me run this. Here also same thing, and don't assume that both are same. Okay. So let me use hi and click on go. Nice. Here we mentioned the servlet one, right? But it is not servlet one, it is first servlet. Okay. And see, let us try one second. Just refresh this. Okay, has this. Welcome has. Welcome hi. Yes. So what they are doing here is, what is the concept name? URL rewriting. What is meant by URL? This is nothing but URL. In URL rewriting, what we are going to do is, just a data aithe meeru gurtu pettukovalani anukuntunnamo manam further further request ki aa data ni manam url lo append chestam. Okay, this is nothing but url rewriting. This the data will be appended to the url. Whatever the data you wants to forward to the next servlet, you will assign that data with the next servlet. Okay, so this is nothing but URL rewriting. See how we are appending the data to the URL. Previous ga manam appending cheyaledu, just by using the get request the data will be transferred, means transferred along with the URL, right? So now this time we are specifically mentioning like this. See here, get parameter, we are giving welcome message to the user, and then we are appending the user name to the query string. So this is nothing but URL. Okay, so ahref the servlet to question mark, appending this is key and this is span. Okay, this will be printed. Okay, see, welcome, hi, a visit. This becomes a link, right? So by clicking on this visit next, I get some mistake. Servlet 2. This is not servlet 2. This is second servlet. Okay. Okay. Second servlet. I'm saving this. Server is restarted, right? So let us refresh and go back. So click on hi. Okay, welcome, hi, visit. So this is again a URL. Okay, so what is URL mean? This URL is redirecting you to another page. Along with redirecting, it is what it is doing. What it is appending the username to the next servlet, right? So whenever you do like this, this data will be transferred to the next request, right? Means it will be displayed like this. If you click on this, next data will be appended like this, and the control will be transferred to the second servlet, right? Here you are getting the data by using get parameter. This is the main thing. You will get data from the client. Okay, so if you want to redirect from this page to another page, here also you need to do the same thing. Okay, you need to do, okavela meer multiple parameters ni pass cheyalanukunte, means you wants to save some more data in the form of mean you want to send some more data to handle session, means ఒక పారామీటర్ సరిపోతేది ఇంకో పారామీటర్ కూడా పాస్ చేయాలి. దెన్ యూస్ ద సేమ్ థింగ్ హియర్. ఓకే, అండ్ ఆఫ్టర్ దిస్ అపెండ్ వన్ మోర్. ఓకే, యూజర్ నేమ్ లైక్ క్వశ్చన్ మార్క్ PWD ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్స్ టు లైక్ like this. If you want to send some other, you can. Do you see? Password is also transferred along with this. Okay, now something went wrong here. Something went wrong here, actually. See the quotations, means the quotes properly. Okay, actually it is doing well, but this is printed extra, not extra. String. It will start get parameter. What's the PWD, right? Let us try to get this. Computer test. Let me restart this. So we are getting none, right? still. Try to sort it out. Okay. And this is for today's class. Do you have any questions up to this? Let me know. And we will discuss about sessions in the next class. Okay. So session management, HTTP sessions is the last class. If I take any extra class, it will be on further learnings. Okay. ఫర్దర్ గా మీరు దీని కంటిన్యూషన్ ఏం నేర్చుకోవాలి ఏం నేర్చుకోవచ్చు అని నేను కండక్ట్ చేస్తాను ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ పాసిబుల్ ఓకే అదర్వైజ్ ఓన్లీ వన్ సెషన్ విల్ బి కండక్ట్ ఓకే సో అబౌట్ ఎగ్జామ్ ఐ విల్ ఇంటిమేట్ యూ అర్లియర్ ఇన్ ద వాట్సాప్ గ్రూప్స్ ఓకే ఓన్లీ ఇన్ ద వాట్సాప్ గ్రూప్స్ నాట్ ఇన్ ఎనీ అదర్ మీడియం ఓకే సో ప్లీజ్ లెట్ మీ నో ఇఫ్ యూ హ్యావ్ ఎనీ క్వశ్చన్స్ Okay, thank you for the session, and we will see the continuation in the next class. Okay, I will try. Okay, this is what I am talking about. Okay, further learnings will need to make next day in which coach you and then possibilities and you could explain last time. Okay.